Hey everybody, got another feature highlight for you in Fusion 360. Today we're actually going to be covering a feature called Boundary Fill. If you find this video helpful, you like this tutorial, definitely hit that subscribe button and the bell icon. I have a lot more of these tutorials coming out for Fusion 360 as well as other design programs like SolidWorks. So let's just jump on over to Fusion. So I've just kind of thrown in a couple different random shapes, have a coil and a box and a sphere, and anyways we're going to go to create and we're going to drop down, and we down near the bottom got boundary fill. Now at first glance it's a lot similar, there's a lot of similarities to the combine feature, but there are a few differences. So we're going to click on this and it's going to prompt us to select tools, and let's just select all three of them for right now. And so you can see it's creating all of these different sections that you can select. So we're going to go to select cell. And now we're given the option to select any of these. So first off, let's just select these three in the middle and this guy. So you kind of see a little bit darker areas that I've selected. And let's remove tools. So pretty much any of the shape that's not going to be saved, we're just going to disappear and click new bodies. We have options for join, cut, intersect, new component, new bodies. Okay, we'll click OK. And you can see that's right there. So this is one of the main differences between this boundary fill and with the combine feature, is you're able to select individual sections that are overlapping rather than just two bodies that are overlapping. So let's say I didn't want all three of these coils. I only wanted the top one and the bottom one. I have the ability to customize just those ones. So that's really, really nice. But let's go back and edit that feature. One of the things you have to know about it, though, is if you're doing a join, if it's overlapping, that's not going to work because you're going to join them and that's just going to, it's already there. You're not creating anything new. So let's uncheck these that are on the internal, the inside. And let's just say we'll do this one and we'll do this one right here and we'll click OK. Oops, I got rid of the tools. My bad. So we want to keep the tools there. Click OK. So now what we can see is we have three bodies. We have the sphere, we have the cube, and then we have the body three. But as I turn this off, you can see that it still kept this one that I had selected. I could have sworn I selected the sphere as well. I did. Oh, but it's not touching it. So in this case, it wasn't liking that because it's just without selecting this piece right here, it's an infinitely thin connection. It's actually not technically touching. So we'll click OK. And now we should be able to see. Yeah. So we have a sphere there. That's the tool. But now we have this piece right here that has the custom pieces that we joined together. What we can also do, let's go back. We'll edit this again. We can do a cut. And again, that one, it has to be on the inside. So we're going to deselect anything on the outside. And we'll select some of these ones on the inside. And we'll click OK. And you can kind of see already if we hide these other bodies, how it's cut out in those chunks. We're going to bring them all back. Edit feature. And then we also have the intersect, which is very much the same. It's just whatever is checked and what's overlapping. We'll click OK. You can see it's keeping those parts. So a lot of the features are very, very similar to the combined feature up here. The only difference is you have the customizability to select individual parts. So it's something I've never used, but completely honest, I actually like better than the combined feature. And I definitely will be using more often just because there's a lot more customizability. And yeah, it just really opens up a lot of possibilities. If you found this video helpful, hit that subscribe button. If you have any questions or comments or requests for other features, I'd love to hear them down in the comments below. And as always, keep on modeling. We'll see you.